Now, for today's video, we're going to talk about the ABG analysis or the arterial blood gas analysis, quick, fast interpretation, and other tips and techniques that I'm going to share with you guys. Now, in NCLEX, they always give a scenario and you will choose answer based on metabolic and respiratory alkalosis or acidosis. They don't give like a complicated test like compensated or uncompensated or something, but this one will help you very quick and fast and easy to analyze the arterial blood gases analysis. So without further ado, let's start. Okay, now let's first understand the normal values. Of course, these are our basic, specifically your pH or the acid and the bicarbs. Now the pH, please remember this by heart, okay? Don't confuse 7.35 to 7.45. And then the bicarbs is 22 to 26. So, okay, what is a normal pH? 7.35 to 7.45. What is a normal bicarbs? That's 22 to 26. Now, these two I just add here, but we're not gonna pay attention for this one little bit when going to do the ABG. The partial pressure of the carbon dioxide is 38 to 42, and the partial pressure of oxygen is 94% to 100%. Okay. Now, the direction of whether it would be acidosis or alkalosis, we have to remember Rome. Okay, R stands for respiratory opposite direction, okay? While metabolic is equal direction, okay? So it means they have the same. Remember Rome, okay? Rome, R is respiratory opposite and metabolic equal, okay? Now the pH dictates whether it is acidosis or alkalosis, okay? Remember that, okay? Now, if the pH decreases, it means it turns acidotic or acidosis. Now, if the pH increases, it means it turns to be alkalosis. Example, what is the normal pH again? 7.35 to 7.45. So therefore, example here, if the pH is 7.25, so it means it decreased, that is acidosis. If the pH increase 7.49, it means they are turned more alkalotic, okay? Remember that, guys. So if the pH decreasing, it turns acid. If the pH is increasing, therefore that is alkalosis or base. Okay, then the bicarbs is 30, the normal is 22 to 26. Therefore, more it turns alkalotic. Decrease, it turns acidosis, okay? Okay, moving on, I hope you learned that, okay? What is the normal pH? 7.35 to 7.45. What is the normal bicarbs? 22 to 26. Example, okay. Okay, let's give example here. pH is 7.49, PaZO2 is 34, bicarbs is 29, okay, and the PaZO is 74. The two most important is the pH and then your, sorry for that, bicarbs. Okay, what is the pH? 7.49, increase or decrease? It increase, therefore it is acidosis or alkalosis? It is alkalosis, okay? Alkaline. Now it is increase. Okay, now how about the bicarbs? The bicarbs is 29. Increase or decrease? Increase, okay, because the normal is 22 to 26. What is the direction of both increase and increase? Therefore, remember Rome. If that is same direction, therefore it is metabolic. Okay, you should write metabolic. What is the direction? Equal metabolic. What is the pH? Alkalosis. So therefore the answer is metabolic alkalosis. Get it? Yes. Okay, next, moving on to another example. What is the pH? 7.52. PaZO2 26 bicarbs is 18 and PaZO2 70. Okay, now collect the data of the pH and the bicarbs. Is the pH increase? Yes, increase because 7.35 to 7.45. Okay, alkalosis or acidosis? Alkalosis because it increased. Okay, let's do it. Bicarbs, 18. Increase or decrease? It decreased. Okay, what is the direction? Remember Rome, is opposite or equal? It is opposite. So therefore, if that's opposite, that is respiratory. Is that alkalosis on the pH or acidosis? It is alkalosis. So therefore, that is respiratory alkalosis. Get it? That's how it is. Next, another example. Okay. pH is 7.31, the PaZO2 is 37, and the bicarb is 19, and the PaZO2 is 90. Okay, now collect the data of the pH and the bicarbs. It's a pH, what is this? 7.31. The normal is 7.35 to 7.45. Decrease or increase? Decrease. If decreasing, acid or alkali? It is acid. Okay, bicarbs, increase or decrease? Decrease. So therefore, Okay, what is the direction? The direction of Rome is it equal? So therefore, that is metabolic. Acid or alkalosis? The pH dictates acidosis. So therefore, that is metabolic acidosis. You get it? So that's how it is easy. So therefore, that's like a bonus question when you got an answer from that. Okay, so this is how you compute for ABG analysis. Okay, moving on. Now on this topic, sometimes they ask questions regarding about the symptoms of arterial blood gases. So and you will know if that is a respiratory or metabolic alkalosis. Okay. Now, for respiratory alkalosis, if the client is having a fast breathing, therefore, he eliminates carbon dioxide. Remember, anything that is carbon dioxide is acid. So if the client is fast breathing, it eliminates the acid, therefore, the base remains, so that is alkalosis and respiratory. Okay, now if that is metabolic, alkalosis, especially remember when you vomit, when you suction, when there's lavage, you are eliminating the acid of your stomach. Therefore, what will remain is the base. Therefore, metabolic alkalosis. Okay, remember that. Next, for acidosis, if you have slow breathing, if you have like a diseases like a COPD where in the air are trapped, therefore, if the air are trapped, therefore the carbon dioxide is trapped, it remains on your lungs, therefore carbon dioxide remain, therefore that is an acidosis because carbon dioxide is an acid, okay? So anything that is COPD, like for example, your asthma, emphysema, pneumonia, so those are acidosis, respiratory. Check on that. Next, if that is a metabolic acidosis, anything that you below like diarrhea, you eliminate your base or your alkali, remove the base by half of the body, like for example, have diarrhea, that is your acidosis, okay? Metabolic acidosis. How about for renal failure, acute renal failure? Of course, metabolic, because they keep producing an acid on the body, that is metabolic acidosis as well. Those who have the diabetes mellitus, metabolic, okay? Anything that is your GIT system, your kidney, so those are example of your metabolic acidosis. Okay, moving on. Okay, questions. Okay, next. What if the outcome if the client is hyperventilating or fast breathing? Respiratory alkalosis because you're removing your carbon dioxide. Asthma. The asthma is COPD, therefore you trap the air. That's respiratory acidosis, okay? This is acid, and number one is alkalosis, okay? How about diarrhea? Metabolic acidosis, because you remove your base. Diabetic ketoacidosis, from the word acidosis, therefore that is a metabolic acidosis. Emphysema is a COPD, you trap the air. That's respiratory acidosis. Okay, very good. Nausea and vomiting, lavage of your acid in the stomach, therefore the base remain metabolic alkalosis. Pneumonia, COPD, therefore respiratory acidosis. Heart failure. What is this heart failure? Respiratory acidosis, because it traps the oxygen in the lungs. Okay. Acute renal failure. Metabolic. It produces acid, therefore metabolic acidosis. That's all. I hope you learn from that quick review of the ABG analysis. I hope you learn from me. And if you do, I'm so thankful that I'm sharing my knowledge to you and be able to progress and proceed to your passing your NCLEX. Thank you so much for watching, and God bless us all.